Good morning, Eisenhower.
I'm your host, Maya, along with Lauren.
Today is Monday, June 23rd, Day B.
Today in history, on June 23rd, 2013, Nick Wallendahl becomes the first man to successfully walk across the Grand Canyon on a tightrope.
You may
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated.
And now for today's announcements with Leah and Emily.
Good morning, I'm Leah along with
Emily.
What does today's weather look like?
Sunny to partly cloudy today with a high of 82. A few clouds tonight, and the low will be around 60. Tuesday will be partly cloudy with a high of 83. There is a 0% chance of rain on Tuesday, so it looks like an outdoor promotion ceremony for the 8th graders. Now here's Leah with today's announcements.
Thank you, Emily. Celebrate the beginning of summer with a delicious treat from Red Mango. Today, tomorrow, and Wednesday, just mention 3R's Day, and Red Mango will donate $1 for every item you purchase. Help support a great cause and have a great treat at the same time. The PTO will be hosting a snack sale today, Tuesday and Wednesday during lunch periods. Snacks and water will be provided for $1. Please bring small bills. Proceeds will help fund 3R's Day next year. Here's Emily with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Leah. The good news is that we have extra yearbooks for sale. If you did not pre-order one last fall, you can still buy one now. The cost is $50 and they won't last long. See Ms. Sloan if you are interested in one of these yearbooks. Also, autograph supplements are available for the yearbook. They are 8 extra pages for all your autograph needs. They are $1 each and are also available in the library. Is Eisenhower celebrating?
Eisenhower wishes a happy birthday to Jamie in 7F. There is no lunch for the rest of the week because there are minimum days. What's in the headlines?
Secretary of State John Kerry arrived in Baghdad this morning to urge the Iraqis to bridge their differences and encourage them to form a new inclusive government.
And now for today's feature with Patrick
and Gavin.
Thanks, Emily and Leah.
Man, there are so many memories here at Eisenhower.
And especially on Team 4.
Let's watch this feature in Eisenhower Memories.
Eisenhower is a memorable place where new exciting things happen every day. Everyone has their favorite memory, whether it's a certain teacher, class, or field trip. Even though we're only here at Eisenhower for a short 3 years, amazing things have happened. So Eisenhower, what's your favorite memory?
What's your favorite Eisenhower memory and why?
I think my favorite is winning the student faculty basketball game because we worked so hard, and it was just like the first time we had ever won. So, yeah.
Thanks!
I'm here with Kyle, and what was your favorite Eisenhower memory and why?
The Hoops for Heart Foundation, because I had the record for Hotshot Blitz.
Thank you. Hello, I'm here with Ms. Philpott, and Ms. Philpott, what was your favorite Eisenhower memory and why?
My favorite Eisenhower memory. I'm not sure it was my favorite Eisenhower memory. I think it was my student's favorite Eisenhower memory was when the bottle rocket came down and I didn't get out of the way and it hit me. They were really quite amused.
I'm here with Mary Claire and Danny. So what were your favorite Eisenhower memories and why?
Frost Valley, because we were with all of our friends and it was like a big sleepover.
Amazing Race, because you got to compete with like a bunch of different people.
Thank you.
You're Grace, what was your favorite Eisenhower memory and why?
Winning the championship for the girls' EMS basketball team.
Why was this your favorite memory?
It was fun to connect with all like the 7th graders and also the 8th graders and play together.
Monica, what's your favorite Eisenhower memory and why?
I think Miss Burns kind of made my whole time at Eisenhower. She was amazing, and I love her so much. What a great science year.
Thank you. Looks like Eisenhower's had some pretty memorable moments.
Wow, I'm going to miss Eisenhower next year.
Same here. Tomorrow's feature is on a dance feature everyone is going to enjoy.
And now back to our hosts, Lauren and Maya.
Thanks, Patrick and Abby.
And now for the joke of the day.
Sorry. Oh, my God. Why did Mickey Mouse take a trip into space?
Why, Maya?
He wanted to find Pluto.
Congrats to Ms. Traffic Candy's Homer for overall winning the ETV quiz questions with 7 first place wins and 9 second place wins.
Today's closing video is of Ms. Traffic Candy's homeroom.
Thanks for watching, Eisenhower. Have a half day Monday.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.